Nowadays, do-it-yourself wireless smart temperature and humidity sensor that can be added in Home Assistant can be very easy and cheap, especially if you have a complete guide like this one that will show you all the steps. I will try my best to show you everything, what parts are needed, how much they cost, from where to buy them, how to connect them, how to configure them, how to install ESPHome, and finally, how to add your smart do-it-yourself temperature and humidity sensor to Home Assistant. On top, if you have access to a 3D printer, I will also show some enclosures that can make the sensor look better. So, buckle your belts as we are starting with the needed parts for this DIY temperature and humidity sensor. The first thing that you will need is an ESP8266 device, and I'm going to use a Wemos D1 Mini. This is the device on which I will install the ESPHome software. Also on the D1 Mini, I will attach a temperature and humidity sensor, which is looking like this. The exact model of the sensor that I'm going to use is DHT22. I will also need three female-to-female jumper wires, or also known as DuPont wires. Of course, if you have other suitable cables, you can use them instead. The final thing that is needed is a micro USB cable and optionally an USB adapter if you have plans to plug this cheap and smart temperature and humidity sensor in the power socket. As I already said, this USB adapter is optional, as you can just plug the sensor in any USB port that you have available. All components will cost you around $5 to $6, and you can buy them using the AliExpress affiliate links in the video description. At the end of the day, it is not so important from where you will get the needed parts, but how you will connect them and how you will configure them. So, moving to the next step, which is how to connect D1 Mini and the DHT22 sensor together. D1 Mini comes with these pins, and these pins are not soldered, so I recommend to solder them, as later on, plugging the jumper wires will be pretty easy. I'll connect the plus output on the DHT22 to the 3-volt pin on the D1 Mini. Then I'll connect the middle output of the DHT22, that is the data, to the D2 pin on the D1 Mini. And finally, I'll connect the minus on the DHT22 to the ground pin on the D1 Mini. This is how everything looks like at the end. Next step is to upload ESPHome software on the D1 Mini device. There are multiple ways doing this, but I'll use one of the easiest, which is to install ESPHome add-on in the Home Assistant. If you don't have Home Assistant yet, I will leave some links in the video description where I'm describing how to install one. So, let's see how to install the ESPHome add-on. I'll go to Configuration, Add-ons, Backups and Supervisor. I'll click on the Add-on Store. And I'll search for ESPHome. Here it is. I'll click on it. This is quick documentation and examples of the ESPHome, and I'll click install.
Few minutes later.
After several minutes, the ESPHome add-on is installed. There is no explicit configuration that you should do. You can double check the documentation if you wish to change something. I'll enable this show on sidebar switch. I'll enable also auto update, and I'll enable watchdog, and then I'll click start. I'll wait a bit more for the add-on to load up, and then I'll click on open web UI. Great, I have new device buttons, they are exactly the same, and I'll click on them. This will be the name of my device. I'll name it D1 Mini. Temperature and humidity. The network name will be A3, and I'll enter my password. Then I'll click next. From here you can select an ESP32, ESP8266 device, or you can pick a specific board. And because I know what's my board, I'll select this, and from the list I'll search for Wemos D1 and Twimo's D1 Mini. If your board is different, please select it from the list or choose more generic options listed above. Then I'll click Next. Configuration created, install. I'm almost ready to install the ESPHome on the D1 Mini, but first I have to edit the ESPHome configuration just a little bit. This is needed for the D1 Mini to recognize the attached DHT22 sensor. I don't want to install the ESPHome yet because I want to edit a bit the configuration, and I'll cancel this. Instead, I'll go to Edit. This is the initial configuration, and I want to add few lines below defining where my DHT22 sensor is connected. I'll get it from the ESPHome.io website. This is the documentation for my sensor, and this is the configuration that I need. I'll copy these lines and I'll paste them here. I'll change the update interval, for example, to 20 seconds. Time to install the ESPHome software on the D1 Mini, which is not hard at all. Then I'll hit save, and only after that I'll hit install. This is the same dialog as before, and I have four options here. Wirelessly requires the device to be online. I didn't manage to make this work for some reason. The second option is plug into this computer, but this requires HTTPS access to the ESP dashboard. So if you manage to configure your ESPHome to use SSL certificates, you can choose this option and you can connect your ESP device to your computer where you're currently performing this operation. Otherwise, you should connect your ESP-based device to the device where Home Assistant and ESPHome dashboard is installed. This is pretty important. Please connect your future temperature and humidity sensor, in my case that's D1 Mini, to one of the USB ports of your device where Home Assistant and ESPHome are installed. In my case, I'm using a Raspberry Pi, and on this Raspberry Pi I have a Home Assistant, and on this Home Assistant I install this ESPHome add-on, so I'll plug my ESP device into the Raspberry, simple as that, and I'll select this one. It detects my USB port, I'll select it. The ESPHome firmware installation is started, and I'll hope for the best.
Few minutes later.
Success! I see this green label here, that means everything is fine until now. But it is time to write ink. Okay, I have some readings. Everything seems very, very nice. I think I have a humidity and temperature sensor ready to work. Here are the readings. 19.4 Celsius and humidity. Good, very, very good. I can stop this. I have a quick challenge for you. If you reach this point and you manage to install ESPHome on your future smart temperature and humidity sensor, let me know in the comments below by just type THOME, where TH stands for temperature and humidity. I'll be very, very happy to see such hashtags there. Now, let's finish this by adding the D1 Mini and the DHT22 Smart Temperature and Humidity Sensor in Home Assistant. My D1 Mini with the attached DHT22 Temperature and Humidity Sensor is online, and now I just have to add it to my Home Assistant dashboard. For that, I'll go to Configuration, Devices and Services. And here it is, D1 Mini TH is ready to be configured. I'll click on this. Do you want to add the ESP node D1 Mini TH to Home Assistant? Of course, I want to do that. That's fine, finish. And I have one device with two entities. If I click on this, I can see my readings. The living room humidity is 58%. and living room temperature. Of course, if you want to do that, you can change these names in the ESPHome configuration. But anyway, the most important thing here is that my cheap temperature and humidity sensor is working great, and from now on I can create automations and scenes and scripts if I want to. For around 5 to 6 US dollars and several minutes, I made a smart temperature and humidity sensor that can be used in Home Assistant, making my home even smarter. Try this out and you can have the same. The only thing that is missing is a 3D printed enclosure. And here is what I managed to find and print on my Ender 3 V2 3D printer. I will leave a link to the 3D model in the video description if you want to print the same. Feel free to secure this channel existence by using any of the supported methods listed in the video description. Follow me on Twitter and join my Discord server. And remember, home smart but not hard. I'm Kirill and I'm done speaking. Bye!